Hi guys. It's a lovely day, better day than it was yesterday at least. The old popo is sitting in the car park for some reason. I've been there all morning. Although the truck was parked over there. Here comes one of my neighbours. Got a new toy to play with. Well, this was just going to get thrown out anyway. This was round the corner where I got all those Christmas lights and whatnot from. That were being dumped, so I thought I'd rescue this as well. That would have just gone in the gone down the dump as well. Can you tell I've been cleaning my bike with it? Actually, I've already cleaned one side of this bollard, so that's partly for part bike dirt, part bollard dirt. Anyway, I'm cleaning it down as best I can. Vacuum out the inside because it's full of cobwebs. Right. Be my nice novelty lamp to go and sit up that corner. Hopefully, a little bit of polish. If anyone wants to make one of these as a novelty lamp, don't go nicking them off the roundabouts. Or anywhere. If you find one that's been dumped in a hedge somewhere, then by all means take it. That just means the council will come along, pick it up and dump it anyway. Because I never put them back. They just replace them with another one. Almost like there's grease or something all over this. I don't know how grease got all over it. Oh, your reflective stickers are coming off. This has actually been sitting in its current location for about 3 years. There we go. Getting somewhere. One more side. Now, these are actually heavier than you might think. For a lump of plastic. Well, for a lump of flexible plastic. Because, these bollards are designed to flex if a, vehicle hits them. I don't know. If I ever see any more or any kicking around in a hedge, because I have seen them before, and I might grab another one if it's a different design to this one. I've got to try and stand the thing up with one hand. Whee! Oh. I'm not sure why it's got a hole in the top. Is that for a I wonder if that's to let light in for I've forgotten the bloody name of it. One of those light sensors. Photocells, that's the one. Yeah, it's not perfectly clean. I could try and, well, I think what it's showing is just scuff marks. Right. So now I've got to find a lamp to put in it. Now I know I've got a few options. Excuse me, Nemo. I've got to get to under the bed. Sit down there for a moment. Because under the bed, amongst other crap, I've got this little box of electrical bits and bobs. Just an out of assorted crap, really. I've got these RCD plugs. You actually wire them onto your appliance, and it's actually an RCD. They call that power breaker, but it does the same thing. strip light. I could stick that underneath it. This is plug in RCD. Timer. Another one of those plug RCDs. Plenty of plugs, plenty of adaptive bloody. This is aerial amplifiers, TV signal amplifiers, whatever you want to call them. Metal box, dimmer switches, galore. that's not what I'm looking for. Ouch. That's what I'd be looking for, something like this. Hopefully I can secure it in place if I can find something to make a hole the size of that lamp holder. Got anything else suitable in here? This is, I've got a switched one, but that's not going to be a lot of good considering it's going to be up underneath the bollard, is it? Mind you, I could always leave the switch in the on position. There's another switched one. Awkward doing it like this. Some more of these adapters, which I do not like using myself. Telephone, it's not a proper old one. Look at that. It's got the old British Telecom logo on it, the really old one. Lots of plugs. If I get fancy and put a brass one in there, then I'd have to piss around earthing it, and I can't be arsed with that one. Some more of these. Should we go vintage style? I do think that first one I pulled out is probably the best option. I'm just trying to read if there's anything written on this. It's made in England. I want to make. It's got rock written on it. Ranton rock? This weird one. Whoops. There's the terminals, and there's nothing to screw on the back of that. It's actually a lamp holder. Can't remember where I got that from. I think that was, if I remember rightly, that was on something a friend of mine picked up to go down the dump, and I rescued the lamp holder out of it before it went to the dump. Look at that. Brand spanking new phone socket there. There's no cutouts been knocked out of it, see? None of the knockouts are gone. Brand spanking new. Oh, hello. Oh no, that one. That one's not quite new, it's had a knockout knocked out of it. Oh dear, why I keep them. I'm never going to use the epoxy thing. Why did I throw that lamp holder? Oh, here it is. Oh no, I've got to get up. I've got to find some cable for it. Ah. I may also need, I might make a bit of room, my hole cutter. Probably going to be my best option. So I've got all these assorted hole cutters, which can go on a cordless drill, so if I find one to match this as close as possible, I can just hole cut a hole in the bottom and fix it using the skirt piece here. Should unscrew. Need to end. There we go. me a bit like a giant lampshade. I'll just use that and poke that through the hole I'll make in the bollard and then screw that down. That should hold the lamp holder in place perfectly fine. I've just got to see if I've got a hole cut close to that. Well, I think these top ones are going to be too big. I want to get the bastards out. Come on. Something tells me they haven't been out of this holder for a while because they're not coming out. There's the... Oh, I see. I see it's me doing it wrong. Oh, I see. You've got to rotate them and then lift them out. Ah. Yep. Sounds like the town crier's out with his bell again. I'm just going to take them all off. I think this one might be close size. Ooh. Actually, I think that would be almost perfect size. Got another one here which I think is going to be too small. Yeah. So I think my best bet is to use that one. Putting it back in the holder upside down isn't going to help. I'll let you in for a little secret. This is the first time I've actually used my hole cutters. So, hole cutter is set up. So, I'm going to go and get a cordless drill and see if I can make a hole. So, I'll be back shortly. Okay. So that's what it's going to look like. And there it is. Crap in the bomb there to get out. Yeah. Hole cutter worked pretty well. Cut quite a nice, neat little hole. Because the plastic flexed, I couldn't press down too hard on it. Just, clear a bit of room so I can stick you, I don't know, there or something. Turn a light on. Move my tools out of the way because I've now got to make the lamp up itself. But I just want to clear the whole car. Might get out. Get the drill bit out of the lump of plastic as well. There you go. One for a plastic disc. Shake that out. Get this all cleared and I suppose I better start with the small one and work up. As the small one's got to go in the centre. There we go, one. Two, is that the next one? That's all I've got to do, you just got to I can't even remember where I got this from. It's the first time I've used it though. It's not the sort of thing I'd use very often. Ah, there we go. I was going to say I'm certain that was the one. Handy little things to have, especially for little DIY projects like this. Get the damn things in. Go on. The larger they are, the more flexible they are, and it seems to be that the more of a pan in the backside they are to get in. Here we go. And just lock it in place. Right. Put that over there out of the way. Now, I've got a 25 watt bulb out as well. I know. Funny angle at the moment because I'm going to put the tripod on the camera if I can get the bloody thing to screw in. There we go. How's that? Any better? That's a bit better. You can see better what I'm doing anyway. So I've got to put. I found this old bit of 2-core cable up I was using for another project. I don't need to use it for that project anymore, so I thought I'd use it for this. Using one of these neon screwdrivers. They're actually supposed to be used as a screwdriver. I'll use them. I'll use anything. If it's got a screwdriver tip, I'll get used as a screwdriver. It's probably safer to use it as a screwdriver than it is as the tester it's intended to be. We've got a little zip tie on the end of this for some reason. I can't remember if that was me that put that on there or if that was already on there. Right, where is that? Let's have a look at the other end. I think I'm going to have to... I was using this for 12 volt circuitry, so I just taped up the damaged bit there. But as this is going to be 240 volt mains, I am not going to keep that like that. That's going to get cut and some new wire bed. If I can. Some of this flex can be quite tough. There we go. Two fresh wires. Now, the screwdriver going to be too big. Oh, ain't that typical? Oh, look, here's a small one I just happened to have. Oh, that's better. Yep, this one's used the cord grip properly. Ever such a simple project to do. Probably do the same with most objects. If you really want to make a lamp out of something. Well, this is the original pendant cable from the look of it, because it's got the tinned ends on the wire. So I'm just going to cut these wires roughly the same length as the original two. That way I know they're the right length for me to use the cord grip that's built into the lamp holder. And again, on lamp holders like this, it doesn't matter what way round you put the wires, like bulb will still work. Or should that be lamp? I know that's the technical term for it. I don't think it matters personally. We all know what we're talking about, whether if we said lamp or light bulb. I suppose if you use the term lamp, that does cover a wide variety of items that light up. Fluorescent tubes, energy savers, all of those. Or it could just be chatting bollocks, who knows. Right. Okay, I'm just going to trim these ends off. They've got to be cut down anyway to go in the plug. Oh joy. Oh, no. Nope. I thought the cable was going to be too big for the hole in the bottom of the lamp holder cover, but no. Oh, numb nuts. Didn't put the cables through the flex grips, did I? I wonder why there's so much blue and brown cable showing. Duh. Right, that's that back. There we go. Okay. You don't want any brown or blue cable showing, do we? Throw that over there out of the way. Oops. So now I've got to put this end into this. It does comply, it has got the insulated pins. mind you, in your own home, you can use whatever you like. It's your own risk. But if I have got one of these free, then I will use them. Oh, that's good. It is fitted with a 3-amp fuse as well. So I haven't got to go and find one. Well, unless this fuse is blown, then I'll have to go and find one. Right. It's got one of these cord grips where you just press the cable into. Like that. It's not one of my favourite styles. I prefer the screw-down clamp ones, personally. Right. I'll cut the wires to size and terminate them. That's the bit I hate with plugs. Cutting the wires to size and then terminating the bloody things. Right. There we go. Pull that off the plug. Pull the pins out of the plug. Oops. Quite enough. Okay. Always want to bear not too much, but not too little either. Almost if you bear too much, you can always trim it down. What way around? I think this is one of those pins that will only go in one way. Some pins and plugs do only go in the one way for some reason. Reasons best known to the manufacturer. One. Let's take the live contact out. Two. Yes, I know I haven't screwed them down tight, but what I do is I get them back into the plug and get them seated where I want them. Like so. Push all the cables in properly. Push the fuse back in. Ouch. It can be a bit sharp. Then I'll make sure that the screws are screwed down nice and tight. In, fuses in, put the back of the plug back on, done. Now, I think, before I actually fit it back to my homemade lamp, I'm picking up rubbish on the way, I'm just going to stick a bulb in and plug it in to test it. Let's see if I can bang or if it does actually work. I'd rather not go bang. On the count of, I'm going to be holding it. I'm going to unplug the battery chargers and plug this in. And, you ready? Hey, I didn't go bang. I'm going to try this 25 watt clear bulb first and see what that looks like. So, thank you down here for a moment. Grab that. I've cleaned the unit inside and out. Missed some cobwebs. Stick in the blob. Stick in the blob. Easier if I use some sort of extension to power this on. Just so I haven't got to lug that to a socket. Let's see what it looks like, shall we? So I'm going to plug that in. Go over to my socket on the wall. There we go. We are lit up. Not as nicely as I was hoping, but I don't think you can actually see it that well from this side. It is lit up. It probably look a lot better in the dark, so I will turn it on again when it's dark, which won't be for several hours yet because it's only coming up to 1 o'clock. simple lamp, novelty lamp. I wonder what my landlord contractors are up to. Sort of thinking I should have put that in the top, but yeah, I think that's all right there. Yeah. Right, so that's it for this video. Just a quick one. Converting one of these old tack bollards into a lamp. Like I said, it's not actually showing up too well in this light. I don't know, once it's shadowed, I think that'll, we'll see what it's like in the dark. I can always, put another lamp holder in there or something. Yeah. Right, that's it for this video. I do hope you, enjoyed it. And, I thought rather than waste it, I'll, rescue this and do something useful with it. Let's just pull the curtains too, very quickly. Oh, that's better, that is lighting up all right. Ah. Yeah. That'd be all right. Or leave it as it is. I don't think it'll make any difference if I put a brighter light bulb in it, so I don't want to start off with anything too bright, because I don't want it to get too hot. But, I think that'll be alright. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again in the next video. Bye!